headline. Give your money, lands, to compensate bandits and killings will stop. Sheik Gumik tells Nigerians and governments. You're welcome to this news. Please listen to the end. The news details. Bandit and Ahmad Gumi. Islamic cleric Ahmad Gumi says bandits have refused to end hostilities against the Nigerian government because they were not given land and enough money. Mr. Gumi said past attempts to broker peace with the bandits failed because they were not compensated with lands or cattle or money big enough to help out hostilities. He added that sometimes the government would just give them, the bandits, $1 million or $2 million and get their weapons without even looking at how they survive. In a live stream on his Facebook page on Tuesday, the self-appointed mediator for bandits said only religion can be used to pacify them to embrace peace. Mr. Gumi had once compared bandits to Niger Delta militants and asked that a federal ministry be established to address their grievances and that of killer Fulani herders. Contrary to Mr. Gumi's stance, Kaduna Governor Aminu Masari openly admitting that Fulanis are the bandits killing and kidnapping Nigerians, said they don't deserve amnesty. The Islamic cleric Sheik Gumi, who has turned himself to a person speaking for the bandits, and said that the Nigerian government, the Nigerians, should give money, lands, food to compensate bandits. That the federal government will just give these people money and weapons without knowing how they live, how they feed. These bandits are terrorizing our country, for crying out loud. And now, an Islamic cleric is supporting those bandits, making it known that we should give them land, we should compensate them. And after we've compensated them, the killings will stop. Is that possible? The killings that have not stopped, all that's why the kidnapping, even after the federal government pays ransom, yet the state still continues. How are we sure that the killings is going to stop even when they have been given money and lands? Those people are agents of darkness, causing uproar, insecurity in the state, killing innocent souls, bombing these Fulani herders, are also part of bandits. They are killing innocent souls. The federal government should arrest Sheik Gumi. The federal government is after the lives of innocent souls. Those ones that are agitating, the hype up that are agitating. And this is someone that is coming out freely, knowing that nobody can harm him, nobody can touch him, saying we should give our money to bandits. Bandits that the Nigerian army are supposed to go and invade their whereabouts. Now, after the federal government have given them money and gotten their weapons for them, the federal government not even look at how they are surviving. Is that something nice? Is that supposed to be so? Are they supposed to do that for the bandits? The bandits that are taking the lives of people anyhow, slaughtering them like cows. This is coming when Sheikh Gumi is a Nigerian cleric who negotiates with bandits. A prominent Muslim cleric acting as a self-appointed middleman, as emerged as a divisive figure in the kidnap for ransom crisis plaguing northern Nigeria, which has seen more than 800 students seized in recent months. Sheikh Ahmad Gumi, a former army captain, was involved in the release of 27 students abducted in March from a forestry college in Nigeria's Kaduna state. Such is his influence that the parents of the freed student paid him a thank you visit, where he assured that 16 other students abducted from Greenfield University in Kaduna state in April would not be killed. Their abductors, who had previously killed 5 of them and released one after a ransom was paid, had threatened to kill the remaining hostages if no ransom was paid at the expiration of a deadline. But the Sheikh said he had talked them out of it. Kidnapping is the lesser evil. Gumi first emerged on the scene in February after he went on a so-called peace mission to a group of bandits in their foreign hideout in Zamfara state. Since then, he has undertaken other such visits to Katsina, Kaduna, and Niger states, urging bandits to stop carrying out attacks. But despite his mandatory role, he has stirred controversy for advocating talks and a blanket amnesty for the criminal groups responsible for the recent wave of kidnapping in northern Nigeria. If the country could pardon coup plotters who committed treasonable offenses in the era of military administration, the bandits can as well enjoy similar forgiveness, even better under democratic rule, he said. Is this right for the federal government of Nigeria? The Nigerians giving out their monies, their lands, their food to compensate bandits so that the killings can stop? Will they stop the killings even if they have been compensated? Please feel free to share your view on this. Thank you.